Hi, I'm architect Sunil Patil from Sunil Patil & Associates, the architect for this building, Collector Office Pune. Collector Office is normally is a district headquarters for the government activities, and people from all the districts come here for getting the works done.
I'm working on this project since last 6 years. When it was decided to construct this project, the basic idea was to construct the project based on the green building concept.
This building is one of the greatest creation of Sunil Patil & Associates. This building is not only an architectural icon, but also a structural wonder.
Constructing this on the very prime location at Pune and surrounded by all government administrative buildings and most busy road.
When we started designing this project, doing a green building was a starting point and not the afterthought. Collector Office Pune is registered with Griha for 5-star rating.
This is the largest collectorate in Maharashtra.
So our main concern while designing this building was to create those public spaces, because you know in India, people observe most of the public buildings. However you design the waiting spaces, they are never enough. The main challenge was that, you know, as the previous campus had segregated small structures, and from circulation point of view, it was quite tiring for people to, you know, go from building to building. Even in case of rain or any harsh sun, it was difficult for them. And Collector Office is such a building where people come from all over the district, and most of them are villagers, and they need to spend a lot of time here, because sometimes I have seen that people spend a complete day getting their work done here and they carry their lunch boxes. So the main thing what we observed and what we wanted to do was to, you know, cater to those people, giving them spaces where they can wait, relax. That space, which is what we have created, is beyond the brief given by the authority. So we created a few things like a huge plaza, which was not in the brief of the project, which is about 10,000 square feet, which will cater to all these people for, you know, for waiting, for having their lunch boxes, or for relaxing. And again in the garden, which we have retained these old trees, which have been converted into some waiting places. The garden plaza is also there for them to do these kind of activities. If you see this building, you know, there are a few features which are not conventional. Like if you see this plaza, which is about 25 meters by 37 meters, which is completely column free. And on top of that, we have the last floor, which is a collector's floor.
Two connecting bridges are provided in between two wings, also having 22 meter span. For that, we have designed a composite section of RCC and steel structure.
And if you observe those bridges, you know, they are spanning about 24 meters without having any vertical support. So these are a few of the special features of this building, which are not just architecturally but also structural excellence. While designing this project, one of our main challenge was to save the trees, existing trees on the site. There are about 197 existing trees on the site, which are more than 30-35 years old. If we had gone conventionally for the designing, we, considering the 2 lakh square feet of the project and the kind of parking requirement, one would have gone for the basement planning. And if we had gone for a basement planning, it would have increased the footprint of the building. And that would have probably forced to cut few of the trees. But we approached this project in a different way. We located a few places where there were minimum number of trees, or there were no trees, and then we created a separate parking building which rises along with the office blocks, and this parking building, parking floors are connected to every floor. So that helped us to save almost all the trees on the existing campus. Out of 197, we had to shift or cut 12, 13 trees.
In addition to saving 170 trees on site, what we have done is we have planted 110 new native trees. With being native, they help in maintaining flora and fauna of the area. Also, the water demand is reduced here because they are native trees.
In the existing campus, there were small buildings, and some of them were quite old, built in stone masonries. So we wanted to recycle those stones. We use those stones for the ground floor of the structures. If we observe, we use stone masonry, and those stone, most of the stones, I mean, at least 40% of the stone is used from the existing old buildings.
Earlier, the building and the structure and all old buildings were there of 1880s, and there were one porch. On that porch, there was a national emblem. And while taking the permission of this project from the Heritage Department, it was given the condition to reconstruct the project, the porch as it is, and reinstall the national emblem.
Biggest difficult challenge for us was preserving that particular monument with the government emblem.
Then we have demolished the earlier porch with a proper accuracy. We kept apart the stones, whatever we have demolished, and from the salvage stone, we have reconstructed the porch at the location decided in the central plaza.
These days, there are either two kinds of buildings in a public sector. One, that they do postmodernist architecture, where they copy historical elements, which we don't believe in at Sripatana States. And the second thing is, when they think about modern buildings, they just think about glass facades. But we wanted to avoid that here, because in a tropical climate of India, when you go for climate response architecture, is that we need good breeze from, and that comes from southwest. At the same time, there's a harsh radiation from southwest. So we need to allow the breeze to come in for good natural ventilation, at the same time avoiding radiation, which probably will hit up the inside area or increase the temperature inside. We avoided glass facades, and we used this fins, which allow us to have good light, but obstructs or avoids, cut the radiation, and we could create good natural ventilation along with the sufficient light in the building throughout. And this building is, if you see this building, hardly 5% of the building is mechanically air conditioned. Rest of the building is completely naturally ventilated and lit.
The spacing between the fins and the detailing is done in such a way so that the internal spaces are in comfort.
If you see this building, every square inch of this building has enough natural light and ventilation.
And we have achieved the thermal and visual comfort for the spaces and for its occupants.
And the main peculiar thing of the project is that we have designed the fifth floor at the level of 25.8 meters levels, and it is having a span of 21 meters. So this kind of structure we never built in the PWD. This is of its first kind.
With the landscape, we are using STP treated water for entire landscape. So all the irrigation demand has been taken care of that. We are also using sprinkler and micro sprinkler technology with a drip irrigation. The landscape is done such a way that the soft area is increased and hard area is reduced as far as possible. So all the pathways, all the parking areas have been designed with grass pavers, and lawn has been maintained, the species are such which require the least amount of water.
We were limited by the specification because it's a government project which has to be done through Public Works Department's specifications of the materials. And that was a big challenge, because most of the green building specifications are not there in the list of PWD's specifications. And for those specifications which are not in the list, we had to get the sanctions from higher authority. And that was one of the biggest challenge, to convince them and to go for those specifications.
Wall to window ratio for this building has been maintained at 38%. We have reduced the use of the glass, and again it's protected with the shading devices. Each glass is designed as per its orientation, as per its function, so the U value of the glass changes according to the usage, and ultimately all this adds up to the comfort. Contributing to the green building All eco-friendly materials have been used for this building. So we have used AAC blocks, which have reduced the structural load. Also, the fly ash has been used in the concrete, also in the mortar. As a part of green interiors, what we have used is we have done metal furniture, where we have saved on a lot of plywood and use of wood. We have used low VOC paints for the finishing. The energy performance index, the EPI of the building, has been reduced by 22.5%.
Architectural project is completely teamwork, and the credit goes to the team, because it's not just me or my associates or my people from my office, but it is important to have a good team of contractors as well. And our team for this project was excellent, whether it was contractors, their supervisors, or whether it was PWD and their officers, even as clients from collector office, collector himself, and then additional deputy collector, and all these people. Right from day one, we were conducting various meetings, and our main aim was to make everybody aware of what we are doing. So the entire team knew what we are doing here and how we are doing it, and what are the green space, what is green architecture, and how we should execute, and that perception about this building, what we as designers had, same thing we wanted the workers on the site who are working here to have, and that happened, that everybody on this site, even the worker who is, even the sweeper, you know, who cleans the site, had the same vision that we all had, and because of that we could really make this building a big success.
The basic objective of the building is to make the administrative functions smooth. And in fact, every minute detail as far as public functioning is concerned, it has been taken care of in drawing and designing of this building. The building has been constructed in stipulated time, and perhaps it's one of the very important records made by PWD and their associates. The building was completed almost in around 3 years of time. Basic facilities and comfort level of the visitors, the rural villagers who are coming from remote part of the district, it has been taken care of, it has been kept in mind. We have shifted in this building around 2 months ago, and almost every Monday I take meeting of all our head of departments, so ICs, and in turn they interact with their team, their staff. We have got very, very positive feedback as far as end users are concerned. End users and stakeholders from both point of views. One, the employees and officers who are working in this building. And second, the visitors, the villagers, the people who visit this building. This building is a green building in almost every sense. Environment protection has been our objective since the very beginning of the construction. In the premises, there were around 197 trees, and today we can proudly say that we have been successful in saving 170 trees. It means only 27 trees got affected. We have got a very huge plaza or atrium, which is around 10,000 square feet, which is beauty of the building, and which attracts the attention of any visitor immediately. We have got very beautiful pathway, landscaping, has been done very beautifully. Multi-level car parking is another unique feature of this building, which usually is missing in any other government building. We see such type of multi-level car parking in commercial places, but not in government premises, which is a very smart way of space management, because Collectorate is situated in a very congested area, and we do not have luxury of open space for car parking. So this effort, this endeavor taken by the architect, it is highly commendable. This building has definitely enhanced the morale of the people, the employees who are working here, and their self-esteem, it has got a boost. I have earlier also worked at various positions, and I can say it with complete authority and responsibility that bearing of our environment, our working environment, it is very important as far as our performance is concerned, as far as our output is concerned.
This building is one of its kind in India as on today for the government buildings, and this building will definitely change the perception of the people towards common buildings, and I hope that this trend will be followed everywhere in India.